In this tutorial, we're looking at how to include implicit repeats in a chart that you're creating from written input. So you're using the written input tool to begin with written instructions and to plug those in and generate a chart. There's a link in the description box below to a more basic video about using that tool. So if that's something you haven't done before, I would recommend starting there. But this video is looking at a very specific little part of the process, which was not covered in that video. Here in front of us, we have a chart. And as you can see, in each round of the chart, there is a knit purl texture that covers more space each time. So it's repeated one extra time in each round. And if we look at the written instructions, we see that we've got knit one, purl one in the first round, then circle brackets with knit one, purl one times two, times three, times four, and so on as the chart goes on. And in order to achieve this in the chart when you're working from written instructions, you need to be quite specific about which style of brackets you use. And in order to chart an implicit repeat, you need to use square brackets. Now, just a quick moment to explain what I mean by an implicit repeat as opposed to an explicit repeat. I have two other charts here to show you. Both of these charts actually knit up to the same thing, but one has implicit repeats, which means that Stitchmastery has inferred the repeat. So you haven't specifically said repeat these stitches, but Stitchmastery sees that there is a repeat and condenses the stitches. So the yarn over, knit two together, Stitchmastery condenses that into a repeat in the written instructions to make them easier to follow. And if we look at the next chart along, we actually have explicit repeats. So repeats that have got a border around them, they've got an instruction to work however many times. You can create this style of repeat from the written input tool by using the square brackets. And we're going to have a look at using some different brackets just to show this in action. So I'm going to click on the new written instructions option and we'll put it in this folder. I'm going to put circle bracket example. And round brackets. Words? I have the instructions here so that I don't have to type them out. So yarn over, knit two together, happening once in the first instance, then twice, three times, four times, and five times, but we've got round brackets. And of course you might opt for an asterisk style repeat rather than, you know, from star to star work three times. Both of those options, so a round bracket or an asterisk, will not result in what you're hoping for. So, round bracket example. We'll generate the chart. And as I've explained, it's not going to chart out the repeat that you've expected. And you would need to go back in and add your repeats. And that will, of course, update your chart instructions. It is copying exactly what you've said, but the tool isn't sophisticated enough to extract the full info for the chart. But if we create one for square brackets, just copy that as well. I have the square bracket version of instructions. And we'll generate that example. Click finish. And here we have exactly the same as was shown in the example. So using the square brackets in your written input generator means that Stitchmastery will write out those repeats in the chart and generate the chart that you're looking for. So I hope that makes sense. Please do feel free to ask questions if anything is not clear. This is mentioned in our Zendesk section on the written input tool. At some point it will be updated in the manual PDF as well, but it is just a sort of quirk of the program that you must use the square brackets if you want to generate implicit repeats in a generated chart.